Fewer state dollars, local school district budget cuts.
Among the cuts considered, summer school, and it could mean more kids than ever home alone. But are yours ready?
KNBC 9's Chris Katz live tonight with ways to know for sure. Chris?
Larry and Laura, good evening to you. If you are thinking about allowing your child to be home alone, the security experts have a couple of tips that we want to give you right off the top tonight. They really like these garage door keypads, which allows your child to get inside the house. That way you don't have to give them a key to get inside the house, a key that, well, they may end up losing along the way. Here's another tip. Think about setting up a place for your child to hide. Maybe it's a closet, maybe it's a bathroom, maybe it's the garage. Some place for your child to hide in case of a break-in, as your child is home alone. This is Anna, 12 years old and just home from school. For her own safety, we won't tell you her last name or where she lives. As soon as she walks in, her first call every afternoon is to her parents. But listen to a phone call no parent wants to hear, a child calling for help.
Who's at your house?
I don't know. He's like a robber.
Where are you at?
At my house.
The story of a 9-year-old in Texas, ending with police coming to the rescue.
Do you ever get scared being home alone?
No.
Why?
Because I know all the doors are locked that I'm going to be safe.
Anna knows to lock the door. She knows never to answer the door. And she knows never to answer the phone unless it's her parents. Does your child know all that?
I had concerns.
Anna's mother, in the beginning, who set rules to be followed in the beginning, like no cooking inside, no playing outside. And just in case, Anna has the phone numbers of neighbors ready to help.
First and foremost, is the child comfortable staying home by themselves?
That's Tom Phillips, head of public safety for the Blue Springs School District, with a question every parent needs to ask. But if the answer is no, Phillips, the former Jackson County Sheriff, says, don't do it. For Anna, being comfortable at home might mean practicing her violin, doing homework, or watching TV until mom and dad come home.
As long as she calls me, I do worry if I don't get a phone call.
Here are three things you need to ask to see if your child is ready. Is your child comfortable being home alone? Does your child know what to do in an emergency? And if there are younger children home at the same time, how does your older child handle conflicts? The answers will go a long way in helping you decide. And here's one more tip. Think about buying a garage door monitor. They're easy to install. They're fairly inexpensive. And what that device will do is it'll flash a light inside if, for whatever reason, your garage door is left open. Here is something else to think about. Half of all children in the United States between the ages of 6 and 13 will be home alone at some part of their day tomorrow. And, of course, much more tips on being home alone to make sure your child does it as safely as possible. Tomorrow morning, First News, again, all week long. Larry and Laura, see you in the morning.
Thank you very much, Chris. If you're still not sure your child is ready, go to our website, KNBC.com. There we have more from security experts on how to make sure your child is ready, along with links to special home alone websites, all at KNBC.com.